Right, I've just got one more package to try and reinstall, which was this Seamonkey. I'm going to attempt to fathom out why it was failing to install. The only thing is, because I've installed a few more packages, I've not got much space left. There's only 6.4 gig left, so I'm going to try the trick that I tried before with the Tune E2FS and set the reserve percentage back to 1 onto the SDA 9. Now, even with that, it only leaves 8.9 gig, so it's 2 gig more than what was required for Seamonkey, but it's still fairly tight. But I'm going to see how I go, see if the space was the issue rather than the memory. So the first thing I'll do is to copy the mozconfig file in the parent directory for Seamonkey and rename it here to just mozconfig. Then I can run in the sed command, just the sed command, and then I can proceed to build this, and I'll time this again. Okay, so it looks like that was eating up a lot of disk space just as it was linking there. So, in fact, it actually says there's time, no space left on device. So I'm getting a, because I've got a different amount of disk space, I'm getting a better message. So what I need to do is make some more space on the drive. And then I can have another go compiling this. So I'm just going to put the video on pause and see if I can make some space and then come back. Okay, so I've removed the TextLive TextMF 2019 package, which is about 3 gigabytes, I think. So if I do DF-H now, yeah, it's about 2.5 gigabytes. So I'm going to try and rerun the build and see if it can actually continue and pass this time. Now it's got 4.5 gig left. So it looked like that used about 2.2 gigabytes of disk space. So that's what the problem was initially. It wasn't memory as I'd thought. It does seem to be completing now. And that's it, it's complete. So now finally I can install it. Okay, we've just got a desktop entry to make, so it appears in the menus, and that should be it. So let me find it under internet. Oh, now it's just updated now, so it should be there now. Yeah, there it is. Hasn't got an icon for some reason. There we've got, let me cancel that. So let's get a new tab up and look at Linux from scratch.org. Oh, if I can type the web address properly, it might work. There you go, into BLFS, read online, and yep, there's the book. Let's try secure website. Yeah, it's come up yellow, so we know it's secure. Let's look at the news. And yeah, that looks like that's working fine. So that's it. Finally got Seamonkey installed, and it was all down to the fact that there wasn't enough disk space on the disk. So I'll be able to put that file back now, which was 2.5 gig. That leaves me with just about 1.5 gigabytes. So we certainly have filled up the 64 gigabyte partition that I created. So thank you very much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed all the videos. As usual, if you enjoyed the video, any of them, please click thumbs up and like it. And if you haven't already done so, click on the subscribe button to hear about my future videos. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.